The National Women's Space, we were once in the Schule that my friend is talking about. We are victims of the eviction, but we are still continuing with our struggle. We still continue to meet regularly like we used to at the Reuterstrasse in Hermannplatz. And I'm going to go straight to my speech just in case somebody has a question, then we can dialogue through questions. If I had been given an equal ground to make a choice between seeking asylum and an option of fucking myself to my bones in order to stay, I would choose the latter. The important aspect is the freedom of choice that we are denied. It is a human right that everybody is entitled to. But Europe arrogantly and unfairly makes a decision for you. Because in their eyes, you are incapacitated. You cannot make a choice because you're not supposed to know how. Therefore, you have to be classified as a second-class human being. Who gave the Western world the right to classify people, to distribute people, to exploit us? They have been coming to our countries with colonialism and its missionary work. They are so-called experts, investors, and charitable organizations. This is pure capitalism as an organized crime. They need to understand that when they come for our resources, we could do trade, but this is never what happens. What actually happens is extortion. So even back in our lands, we are not given the right to choose. Let's give an example of how this happens. Everybody wants to eat bio food, but here the land and the climate is not as fertile as in our lands. So what do? They go and grab our lands, with or without war, but never peacefully. The result is that this action provokes rural-urban migration. People are forced to move to already overcrowded towns, fighting for survival. Still, let's keep in mind that those who will choose to try their way to Europe constitutes not more than 5%. The majority still migrate within our continents. And we are not mentioning wars, mass killings, rapes, and whatever comes along with the neo-colonialism strategy. With this in mind, you must change your perspective on what makes a migrant and a refugee. Our resistance begins in our countries as a response to your invasions and manipulations. It started when they came to colonize. It went through the resistance movements for independence, and it continues here. What is the surprise? Why are you so shocked that we took oplats or occupied the school and made our struggle visible? This is just as a result of your actions. Change your actions and perspective so then we can have a dialogue on equal grounds. Yeah, that's all.